everyone. My name is Angelique Francis, and I am one of your co-hosts for this evening for the special virtual broadcast of the Maple Blues Awards. I'm also a band leader of the blues band, the Angelique Francis Band, and I'm delighted to be joined today by Matt Sobb, the amazing, fine, young drummer for the multiple Maple Blues award-winning band, Monkey Junk.
Thanks, Angelique. It's great to be here with you tonight here in our hometown at Overflow Brewing Company, bringing blues fans the second of four virtual broadcasts that will share the results of Maple Blues Awards voting, with two more February Mondays from Montreal and Vancouver coming up.
In our land acknowledgement tonight, we want to participate in the process of education and recognition of the injustices in our society toward Indigenous people. We acknowledge that we are on the unceded, unsurrendered territory of the Anishinaabe Algonquin Nation, whose presence here reaches back to time immemorial. We recognize the Algonquins as the customary keepers and defenders of the Ottawa River watershed and its tributaries.
This 30-minute version of the Maple Blues Awards will feature performances by J.W. Jones, Crystal Shawanda, also a memorial to folks we have lost this year, and four award categories, including Blues with a Feeling, Entertainer of the Year, and Female Vocalist of the Year. So let's get this show on the road. Let's have a look at our first category, Bass Player of the Year, sponsored by the Ottawa Blues Society.
Right, Matt. And the nominees are Al Duffy, Alec Fraser, Gary Kendall, John Diamond, and Keith Picot.
And the winner is, opening our first envelope here, thanks to Humo Euster at the TBS. John Diamond! You may know John Diamond from his work with Colin Linden, Blackie and the Rodeo Kings, Katie Lang, Bruce Coburn, Steve Dawson, Susie Vinnick. He's a very busy and the consummate bass player with the longest quarter note ever. We'll be delivering John's award to him right away. Maybe he'll be able to show it off at one of our upcoming blues Zooms. This is where the nation's blues community comes together online. Let's keep the awards coming and share the results of another exciting category, Blues with a Feeling, sponsored by the most excellent Stony Plain Records. The BWAF is what got the Maple Blues Awards going many years ago, all the way back to 1985. It all started with the first trophy going to Willie Dixon when he spoke at the Underground Railroad restaurant in Toronto. Willie Dixon, where do I know that name from?
Wow, I wish I was there for that. Our Blues with a Feeling nominees are Alec Fraser, Brent Parkin, Danny Brooks, Joe Murphy, Ken Whiteley, Michael Fanfara, and Tom Lavin. And the winner is oh, wow, we have a tie.
Woo.
The two winners this year are Joe Murphy from Halifax and Ken Whiteley from Toronto. These Canadian blues gentlemen are legends and more than deserve what is essentially a lifetime achievement award. Congratulations.
Congrats, gentlemen. Now watch your front porches for a special delivery of your trophies any day now. Joe and Ken, beware of the porch pirates. I've never been to Ken's house, but I have been to Joe's house. So Joe, you're gonna need to move those surfboards around back to make sure your trophy arrives safely. Right now we have a very special performance from Crystal Shawanda, recorded at her home studio in Nashville with her guitarist and partner, Dwayne Strobel. Crystal is Anishinaabe Kwe, originally from Manitoulin Island, or Wiki, as it's also known, the largest freshwater island in Canada. Crystal broke into music in the country scene, but came to the blues in recent years. Her surname translates to Dawn of a New Day. From her Maple Blues Award-nominated release, Church House Blues, let's settle in and enjoy this intimate version of her tune, Rather Be Alone.
Hi, I'm Crystal Shawanda, and I'm going to sing a song that me and Dwayne Strobel wrote together. This is called Rather Be Alone. Thank you so much to the Toronto Blues Society for everything.
Answer the phone, didn't I? But it's way too late. It's 2:22 and I done gave up on you. Deja vu, the same voodoo. All the magic is gone. It's gone, gone, gone. It's wrong, it's just wrong. And I'd rather be alone. Yeah, maybe I gave in before, but you ain't got what I need. I ain't going there no more. Did you run out of friends? Did you strike out again? Deja vu, I just hung up on you. Oh, the magic is gone. It's gone, gone, gone. And I'm on it when it's on. But when it's wrong, it's just wrong. And I'd rather be alone. It's gone, gone, gone. And I'm on it when it's on. But when it's wrong, it's just wrong. And I'd rather be alone. Oh, I'd rather be alone.
Great to see Crystal and Dwayne all the way from Nashville. We love that she has come over from her country beginnings to join us on this blues parade. Next up, we're taking you to the memorial section of the night. Every year, we acknowledge the loss of our blues brothers and sisters during the awards. And this year, we'll be sharing these tributes across each broadcast. Allow us now to take a moment to celebrate the lives of our dear friends and reflect and recognize the contributions they have made within this community and the role they played in forging a national legacy.
Last week, we honored one of the pillars of Canada's blues scene, John Valentine. And this week, we are sharing the names of more that have fallen in the past year. For musicians and those that knew Michael Fonfara, we were really taken aback when he succumbed to a 2-year battle with cancer. He was one of the greats, and tributes that have appeared across the blues landscape have told an amazing story of a genius and a journeyman. Watch this month for the Maple Blues newsletter for a great profile as well on Stratford's Stu Lang. I knew and loved both these men and miss them both dearly, as well as many who are featured here. Please listen to David Vest's Pretty Things for Annie as we scroll through the photos and remember some of the greats we have lost this year.
And yes, that was a photo of founding Ottawa Blues Society member, the late Rocket Ratchet. Thank you all for everything you have done, for all the lives you have touched, and all the love you have spread. You will be missed. As promised, we have one more performance tonight, and he is a blistering hot homeboy who tailed many a nomination with the latest release, Sonic Departures. J.W. Jones was selected Best Guitarist at the 2020 IBC in Memphis as he represented the Ottawa Blues Society. He represents well. And earlier this month, he laid down a tune right here at Overflow for you to enjoy. Let's hear it now. Here comes Blue Jean Jacket from JW's Sonic Departures release.
Hey everybody, it's an honor to be here at the streaming version of the Maple Blues Awards and an honor to be nominated. We're gonna play a song here that I wrote with Tom Hambridge. It's from the album Sonic Departures and it's called Blue Jean Jacket.
Sundays are Monday movie nights. Wait till Friday to see you walking by at the arcade shooting pool, walking you home from school. My blue jean jacket, I sure felt cool in my blue jean jacket. I felt like I could take on the world. Well, those threads of mine, now you know they felt so fine. Holding my girl, yeah. It was my coat of armor when I had to stand strong. I had a lot of good times and I had that thing on roller coaster rides with my baby by my side. To that blue jean jacket, she held on mighty tight. To my blue jean jacket, I felt like I could take on the world. Holding my girl.
tell. And I might fade, but I'll go to my grave with blue jean memories I remember so well. In my blue jean jacket, I felt like I could take on the world. Well, those threads of mine, oh, you know they felt so fine. I was holding my girl. Take on the world. Well, those threads of mine, they felt so fine. I was holding my girl.
Tune. So sweet to have an Ottawa hometown guy in the house tonight. That session was recorded right here at the Overflow Brewing Company. I'm gonna hold the mic a little longer, Matt. The next category of the night is Female Vocalist of the Year. And I want the opportunity to salute all my blue sisters.
Hey, I wanna salute them too, but that's not my line. Seriously, we'd like to make a comment here about gender balance and a movement in the music industry called Key Change. This is a global movement to improve gender representation that we support. Like Black Lives Matter and improving conditions in Indigenous society, this event tonight is a great opportunity for community building. We encourage you to do your part when making your choices with blues music and all music.
And now, I'm taking the mic back, Mr. Sobb.
Okay.
It is my honor to toast my friends, the incredible woman in this category, Female Vocalist of the Year. This award is sponsored by Limestone City Blues Festival, a great event, rocking every August in Kingston, Ontario. This year's nominees are Angel Forrest, Crystal Shawanda, Dawn Tyler Watson, Dion Taylor, and Samantha Martin. And the winner is Angel Forrest.
I'm sure there's a lot of happy people in Montreal tonight. Hang on a second. Didn't Angel and her partner, Denis, roll their tour bus all the way out to the pleasant shores of Hornby Island. Mm. What a place to escape the pandemic.
I'll say.
One way or the other, there's a trophy on the way to either Montreal or their mobile trophy rack in their bus. Angel already holds 6 of these awards, so they're piling up. We have one more big Maple Leaf to give away, Entertainer of the Year.
Yes, Matt, this is a coveted award and really speaks to the innovation that takes place on stages and studios all across our great nation. Here comes the Entertainer of the Year. It was a pretty weird year last year, what with not much happening on stages due to COVID-19. Nevertheless, the nominees in this category have been successful at capturing the hearts of audiences all over the country, despite the increasing challenges they faced. What a feat! The people have spoken with their votes. We shall see what they decided in a few seconds. Sponsored by TD Kitchener Blues Festival, the Entertainer of the Year Maple Blues Award nominees are Don Tyler Watson, Downchild, Jack DeKaiser, J.W. Jones, and Samantha Martin and Delta Sugar. And the winner is Don Tyler Watson.
Woohoo! Congrats, Don. Felicitations. Very well deserved. Don is an outstanding artist and has won multiple Maple Blues Awards over the years, as well as taking home the 2020 Juno Award for Blues Album of the Year. This trophy will give her something to smile about next week as she hosts our next edition of the Maple Blues Awards from Petit Campus in Montreal. We look forward to seeing that beautiful smile with Ben Racine as her co-pilot. Well, Angelique, that's a wrap for our second virtual edition of the Maple Blues Awards. And we have some people to thank, of course. We saw some credits roll off the top of the show, but we need to repeat that the Toronto Blues Society would like to gratefully acknowledge the government sponsors, including Factor, through the financial support of the Government of Canada and Canada's private radio broadcasters.
A whole crew of people were behind the show coming together, and we're going to recognize them with credits rolling in a minute. But we also want to acknowledge the financial support of SOCAN Foundation, Ontario Arts Council, and Toronto Arts Council. It has been an absolute pleasure hosting with you tonight, Matt.
Thank you.
See you at the grocery store? Was that Whole Foods or Farm Boy?
Well, I love my Farm Boy, but it's strictly no frills for me these days. I'm a struggling musician, you know. Let's give a shout out to our hosts here, Brad and Mitch at Overflow Brewing Company. Clyde River Productions, who provided the technical aspect tonight, and of course the Ottawa Blues Society.
Let's look at the credits now to see everyone who helped pull tonight together with a tune from the Maple Blues Band playing along. This tune is appropriately called Thanks a Lot. Through the magic of Zoom technology, we are now going to say hello to some friends across the country who have joined us to celebrate. See you there or next week in Montreal.